A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 14th October, on the front page you have first private train violates railway traffic law. So this is regarding country's first private train that has contravened the Railways Act of 1989. Since the central government is the competing authority to decide on tariff and IRCTC itself cannot decide tariff. So this much publicized train service, which was flagged off on the Lucknow-Delhi-Lucknow route, as such, it is charging higher fare than the existing Shatabdi Express and other trains on the same route. Is a problem being raised in this first private train. So, you know, because plans are to have 150 more trains in the private mode. So it is IRCTC, which is a commercial tourism and catering arm of railways, which is tasked with operating these trains. Then this is World Bank cuts India's growth projection to 6%. So after broad-based deceleration seen in the initial quarters of the present financial year, India's growth rate is projected to fall to 6% is what the World Bank has said. So we have seen even RBI has brought India's the country's growth forecast from 6.9% down to 6.1%, and it's World Bank also which projects India's growth at 6.1%. And this is Delhi's air quality slips to very poor category. The graded response action plan GRAP, which is scheduled to kick in on October 15 to check rising air pollution in Delhi, you can see that air pollution levels presently are poor. So it's air quality index which shows them as very poor. The air quality. And these are bullet trains. How bullet trains are submerged in muddy water in central Japan after typhoon Hagibis hit the city. And this is with 9 cases a day, Mizoram is top state with HIV prevalence rate. So people aged 25 and 34 are most vulnerable, and those between 35 and 49 come next. So Mizoram is said to be the top state with HIV prevalence. Then on page 9 you have foreign plastic invades Great Nicobar Island. So researchers have found litter from Malaysia, Indonesia and Thailand on the Great Nicobar Island, which hosts a biosphere reserve. So these are pristine beaches and India's southernmost territory, and they are under threat from plastic. So survey here has shown that plastic from other countries are entering in Great Nicobar Island. So proximity to the island, it's very close to Indonesia, Thailand, as such, which may have caused plastic to make its way into the island through water currents via the Malacca Strait, which is a major shipping route here. Then on editorial page, the first editorial is Chennai Connect. So this is regarding how Modi and Xi government have not allowed recent disagreements to cloud their second informal summit in Chennai, which has been named Chennai Connect. So that is praising the informal summit. And this is Price for Peace. So this is regarding Abiy Ahmed, the Prime Minister of Ethiopia, who has won the Nobel Prize for Peace. Because, and this, the editorial says, must be viewed as a call to end inter-ethnic conflict in Ethiopia. So Ethiopia, it boasts a recognition for peace in East Africa and reminder of the challenges which are ahead of Mr. Abiy Ahmed, the Prime Minister, for resolving the conflicts here in the region. So it's Eritrea with which Ethiopia has conflict. Eritrea got independence from Ethiopia in 1991. And it had fought a disastrous border war during 1998 to 2000. This is the context. The lead article, Scholarship in Times of Populism. So this article says that in these changed times, there has to be reiteration and defense of the basic principles of constitutional democracy. That is highlighted how scholarships as such too have to fulfill the criteria of basic principles of constitutional democracy. And this is a tax policy that could work. So this talks about how multinational companies actually pay their fair share of taxes as such. So if there is political will, then multinational companies will pay taxes. So this is a feasible strategy is what is highlighted in this article, a tax policy that could work. But there is a need for political will. So it details out how the idea works too. It's OECD, Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, the multinational organization, which is actually, you know, has initiative in place which is called BEPS, Base Erosion and Profit Sharing, so that it can be ensured that multinational companies actually pay taxes. They do not evade taxes. So there's an uneven playing field because domestic companies have to pay taxes that MNCs can avoid. So they should not be able to avoid taxes. They should be paying either in the country of the origin or country where they are functioning. So this requires political will, is what has been highlighted, and how it has been put into effect under this two arm's length principle of treating the subsidiaries as separate entities is one point which is highlighted here. And it said biggest problem is the arbitrary separation between what OECD calls routine and residual profits and the proposal that only residual profits will be subject to unitary transaction taxation. So what is routine and what is residual, you know, that is a concern. Only residual profit has taxation on it. So there are concerns with respect to OECD BEPS initiative also. That is highlighted here. On page 13, you have education of mothers directly linked to better nutrition for children. So Pan-India study of 1.2 lakh children by Health and Family Welfare Ministry has shown that children received better diets with higher level of schooling among mothers. So this is a report of the study. And this is Nepal-China Inc. road connectivity deal. So Nepal, with capital Kathmandu, is going to import more from China. And Chinese banks will open branches in Nepal too. So these other deals which have been finalized in Nepal. So after the informal summit in Chennai with India, Chinese President Xi Jinping visited Nepal. On international page, you have US troops set to leave northern Syria. So Turkish offensive, it is said, is likely to extend further. So the situation is untenable for US forces here and they are leaving further. Already, US President Donald Trump had announced troop withdrawal from northern Syria, and now remnant troops of US also would be moving out. And Turkey has been, you know, bombarding the northern Syrian region. It wants to create a safe zone, it says, for the migrants which are there from Syria in its territory. And it also fears the Kurdish rebels, so that's the actual reason. But then this offensive has also led to millions fleeing from the northern Syrian region. And this is Typhoon Hagibis batters Japan, leaves over 33 dead. So this is Typhoon Hagibis, and troops, rescue workers have been deployed to save stranded residents. So you can see the disaster which has struck here in Japan. And this is flash mob protests rock Hong Kong. So police is using tear gas, and though they deny using excessive force, protesters are targeting businesses in Hong Kong. Then on Mondays, there's no business news. You have this money-wise coverage. And also the last page has sports news. So these were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashara.com. Thank you.